Hello and welcome to the newsroom. I am Jerusha Amarigbo. The federal government has inaugurated the Governing Council of the National Commissions for Persons with Disabilities. Minister of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development, Sadia Farouk, who inaugurated the council in Abuja, said the seven-man Governing Council was established to bring the year of exclusion of persons with disabilities to an end. Farouk further said the establishment of the commission will go a long way in alleviating sufferings of persons with disabilities, including seeing to their education, general well-being, employment, and economic development. The Academic Staff Union of Universities, ASU, has conditionally suspended its nine-month-old strike, which started in March 2020. National President of ASU, Biodu Ogunyemi, made the announcement during a briefing of the union in Abuja on Wednesday. Ogunyemi explained that the development followed consultations with the National Executive Council, NEC, majorly on negotiations for the release of funds for the revitalization of universities, payments of lecturers and allowances, and removal of ASU members from the Integrated Payroll and Personal Information System, IPPIS. He also stressed that if the government refuses to fulfill its own part of the agreement, the union will resume the strike action without any prior notice. And a bill with stiffer penalties for perpetrators of domestic violence has passed through the first reading at the Taraba State House of Assembly. Now, Speaker of the House, Joseph Kanini, who sponsored the bill, disclosed this when he hosted journalists in Jalingo. The bill, when passed into law, according to the Speaker, will help reduce incidences of domestic and political violence in the state, as offenders will face sanctions of up to 14 years in prison without an option of fine. The Tunisian government has announced that a nationwide curfew in the country has been extended to January 15, 2021 to curb the spread of COVID-19. Tunisian Minister of Health Ferouzi Mehdi, who announced this at a news conference in Tunis, stated that the curfew is imposed from 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. local time. The measures also included extending the bars on movement between governorates and ongoing demonstration, fairs and meetings, and in addition to the closure of cafes at 7 p.m. local time and ban on New Year celebrations. According to Mehdi, wearing of masks is still compulsory in all places, in addition to the continued application of preventive and hygiene measures. In the world of business, the price of liquidified petrol gas, popularly known as cooking gas, sold to marketers in the country has been risen by over 20% in the past 1 month, with consumers paying more for the product. The Naira plunged on November 30th to 500 per dollar at the Pario market, its lowest level in more than 3 years, from around 462 Naira to $1 at the start of the month. It traded at 476 Naira against the greenback on Tuesday. Marketers said the price of cooking gas has continued to increase in recent months at a depreciation of Naira against the dollar, and increased global demand pushed up the cost of importing and products into the country amid inadequate local supply. Hong Kong media tycoon Jimmy Lai has been granted bail on Wednesday, nearly 3 weeks after he was remanded in custody over fraud and national security-related charges. Lai, an outspoken advocate for democracy in Hong Kong, was charged with fraud on December 3rd for allegedly violating the lease terms for office space for his media company, Next Digital, and was later charged again on December 12th under the national security law and suspicion colliding with foreign forces and endangering national security. Lai appeared in court on Wednesday and was granted bail by the High Court. And Lyon striker Moussa Dembele broke his arm in training and will miss at least the last match before the brief winter break, the Ligue 1 club. Lyon is second in the French top flight and goal differences and entertains Nice on Wednesday. The club said the 24-year-old striker broke his arm on Monday but did not say how long he will be out for. However, coach Rudy Garcia said at his press conference that he fears the player will need an operation. Lyon resumes their league campaign on January 6th against Lens. And that's all we have on our package. Many thanks for staying with us. I am Jerusha Amarigbo.